including me. And you know, with the holidays, we get so bombarded with candy and goodies and sweets, and a lot of people can get on to these sugar cravings and start to want to eat more sugar. Because that's the thing, you know, like the more sugar you eat, the more sugar you want, and it's like this vicious roller coaster that keeps going. So I wanted to tell you a little bit about chocolate today, because I recently got back from Switzerland, and of course they have like the best chocolate ever. But you know, what we can get here is pretty good too, and I want to show you a little bit about that and tell you about that today. So, you know, the stuff that we get that people normally eat in terms of chocolate, Hershey's, Kit Kat, you know, some of this not so good candy that we see around Halloween, it's really crap. I mean, let's face it. So, but chocolate can be good for you, and you can actually, you know, everybody wants a little sweetness in their life, right? You know, we all kind of have that craving for something sweet every now and then. So it's only natural. It's like a human thing. So we want to know, like, what is it that we want? You know, chocolate is kind of like a double entendre. It's good for you, but only if you get the right stuff, right? So the right stuff, you know, this is just to kind of give you an idea. As long as you choose like at least 70% cocoa, it's going to be much better for you than something that's below 60%, because 70%, because, you know, the less it has, the less percentage of raw cacao it has, like the worse, you know, the more sugar it has. So the more bitter it is, actually the better it is for you. So, and then like a little trick, because some of you are like, oh, I don't really like dark chocolate, you know, that sucks for me because I like the white chocolate or the milk chocolate, but I'll give you a little tip. If you put a square of dark chocolate in your mouth and you let it just dissolve in there, there's these enzymes, digestive enzymes actually start in our mouth, and amylase, one of the enzymes that breaks down carbohydrate, actually sweetens the chocolate as it sits there. So you could try that little tip next time you're trying dark chocolate. So the other thing, so I wanted to tell you a little bit about, you know, why it's good for you, number one. And you want to go, you know, if you're making some things with chocolate, the best type is this raw cacao powder. Some people say cocoa. Like, what is the word? Is it cacao? Is it cocoa? Is it tomato, tomato? I don't know. But what, you know what? It doesn't matter. So the raw stuff, it's like the raw, unprocessed stuff. That's what you want. So, the, you know, believe it or not, this stuff, it has more antioxidants than blueberries or acai berries. So this stuff is loaded with antioxidants. So because it's so high in antioxidants, it helps protect our heart. And how it does that is that it protects the bad cholesterol from being oxidized. Because a lot of people have elevated cholesterol, but the worst kind of elevated cholesterol, you know, is when it's oxidized. So the more antioxidants you give your body, the less chance of those particles being oxidated and causing plaque buildup. So it's really high in antioxidants, protects your heart against oxidation of cholesterol. You know, another great benefit of having, you know, raw cacao or dark chocolate, if you will, on a regular basis, is that, you know, it's really good for our blood flow. So like a lot of things with blood flow, lowers blood pressure, you know, guys, if you have trouble in that area, you know, anytime you need more blood flow, it helps with that, because what it does, it contains something called nitric oxide, and nitric oxide increases nitric oxide production, and what that does is that it helps to relax the artery walls, and so whenever they relax, our body could get more blood flow. So that's kind of like a little quick tip about nitric oxide production. So it does do that too. So, and because it increases blood flow, it's also good for our brain. So like the list goes on and on, but you know, it helps our mood. One of the things too, like that dark chocolate does, is it produces that same chemical that we get when we're in love, that phenylethylamine. And that is That is why, probably, that, you know, guys give girls chocolate on Valentine's Day. You know, they're like, whoa, maybe she'll like me more. And it's true. Then we eat the chocolate and we're like, oh, wow, he's actually kind of cute. Just kidding. So anyways, what we do, I also, you know, there's a lot of things you could do with cacao. And you can actually get just dark chocolate and you can have that. And so, but I want to show you, I have like a great recipe on my website, and I'm having some people over for the football game Saturday night, go Canes, right? And so I wanted to make a little dessert for that, and I thought, you know what, I'll share it with my friends. So this is a recipe for raw brownies, and I'll show you how we make that. So the first thing you're going to do is get a food processor. And you want to add about 2 cups of walnuts. This is going to get kind of loud. So we're going to add 2 cups of walnuts to this. And we're gonna make them into like a fine like dust. So like once they're in like a powder, then what you do is you add some more things here. You're gonna add about 3 cups of dates, and dates is what is gonna sweeten that, right? Because the raw cacao powder, it's not sweet at all. It's just like, you know, it's the good stuff. It's really rich. But you're gonna add about 3 cups of dates, and then about a cup, and the medjool dates are really good for this, as long as you take the pits out or you get them pitted, that's good. And about a cup of, what is this? I'm just kidding. This is hemp hearts. So hemp hearts gives it that protein. So you really want the, so the healthy fats of the walnuts and the hemp hearts. But these brownies, these are gonna be like raw high protein brownies because you're adding all these hemp hearts. Right? We just spilled a little, whatever. We get messy in the kitchen, right? It's all good. Messier is better, right? If you don't get messy in the kitchen, you're not cooking. So then you just start that. So you want this texture. So we got the walnuts, the dates, and the hemp hearts. And you want it to get like, I don't know if you've seen those Lara bars, but you want it to get like kind of like that texture. So that's about right. And so then what are we missing? The cacao, right? So we're gonna add that, about a cup of the cacao powder. And I'll go ahead and add a link for you guys to get a big bag, because it's always good to have this on hand, especially like if you're gonna be making some really yummy things with it. You can even make hot chocolate with it, because, you know, with a little coconut milk and maybe a drop of stevia or something, it's so good. And it's like actually healthy for you to do that. So we're going to take vanilla, and you want 3 teaspoons or a tablespoon, same thing. So you're going to add that to the mixture. And then the last thing you add, this is really, you guys, like 6 ingredients. Like, it's so crazy simple. And so what you want to add in your Himalayan pink sea salt, it's the bomb. So I highly recommend this, and you know, it's not bad for you to have a little sea salt in your diet, especially if you're eating really clean. Like, we need those minerals. So then you're gonna add about like a teaspoon. And that's how I add a teaspoon. That little tiny cup in your palm can sometimes be just enough, and that's a teaspoon. So you can tell it really measures. But you can measure it if you want. To each his own, right? So then you just like blend that up. So like what I like to do is just make sure that it's just getting all mixed in here. And And if you find that it's a little bit dry, you can add a little coconut oil. And that's what I'll probably do when I finish this live video. But overall, it's like the texture of a larabar. And then, I don't know if you could see that. So that's kind of like, it comes out like that. So what you're gonna do then is you're gonna push it. So I would add a little coconut oil to that because then it gets a little bit more moist. Because sometimes the dates, it depends. If you're using dates that are a little drier or moist, it's gonna be drier if you're using drier dates. So we'll add a little coconut oil and then mix that up. And then you just push it in the bottom of a pan and freeze it for 10 minutes. And you guys, it's like the best raw brownie. It's just so good. Like, you'll be surprised. Like, if you're sitting there like, oh my gosh, this is disgusting, then you should try it because it's actually really good. And what I like to put with it is a little bit of coconut whipped cream. So that's, again, it's really easy to make. You put a can of coconut upside down in the refrigerator and you let the fat separate. You pour out the coconut water and then you whip that up in a cool mixer and add like a drop of stevia, some vanilla, and you have coconut whipped cream on top of your raw brownie. So we're gonna be having a great dessert this weekend, and I hope you guys liked this Fresh Friday on chocolate. So remember, when you're next time you're choosing chocolate or you're, you know, craving something sweet, go for the quality stuff, because that's always gonna be better. Another thing I wanted to tell you is these protein nut balls I've been making are super, super good. And I even made chocolate. So the kids really love these. You know, my son Ethan, he was so cute the other night. He's like, oh yeah, I wanna try one. So I gave him one and he's like, Lucy, you're gonna freak out. They're so good. So I thought it was so cute. So if you really don't want to take the time to make these protein nut balls for the holidays, I'm going to be making a ton. And let me know. You could private message me and I'll get them out to you, whether you want to give them away as a gift or you just want to keep them like on hand so that you don't indulge in things that, you know, you would normally. Okay, so thanks for joining and happy Fresh Friday. And I hope you guys have a great weekend. Bye.